Someone told me it's all happening at the zoo. I do believe it. I do believe it's true.
Okay, hello, it's Wednesday the 6th, January. A gorgeous, gorgeous day here in San Diego, California. It's gotta be 70, 75 degrees. I don't even need this long sleeve shirt I'm wearing. I could be in shorts and a t-shirt. And we're here at the San Diego Zoo. I brought my sister and my mom. And my niece are with me today, and we're gonna go and see the animals and have a walk around. So I'll film as I go along and edit this together later. So, minasan konnichiwa. Yokoso San Diego Doubutsuen. Say hello.
Hello.
Say hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Okay, ikimashou, let's go. Okay, so there's a bus, if you can see it down here. Like an open air double decker bus, and we're gonna go get on that, and that takes you around the entire park. You can see the sky tram in the distance. And that gives you kind of an overview, and you can get off and on the bus, which is coming by now. So if you wanna get off of the polar bears or the gorillas, etc., and we're gonna do that. And my niece Brittany is going to tell us, what do you want to see today, Brittany?
The tigers.
The tigers? Anything else?
And the elephants.
And the elephants. I think we can do both of those. Of course, San Diego Zoo, one of the most famous zoos in the world. And my mom really wants to see the pandas today, so we're going to definitely see those. And lots of other animals too. Okay? More soon.
They're considered to be the most dangerous animal found in Africa. A lot more human deaths caused by hippos and painting those found out there in Africa. Now take a look behind them and to the right a little bit. You'll see some other critters munching away right now. They got some stripes on their back ends. Those are the okapis.
Those were hippos.
See which animal I'm talking about? Back right
there,
kind of by the trio of palm trees over there.
The hippos were sunning themselves.
A lot of people think that that animal would be related to the zebras, but they're actually more closely related to the giraffes. The reason they have some other long neck is because this way they can reach up a little higher that other gazelles may not be able to reach for food. And they can stand up on their hind legs and reach a little further. These are males. Females do not have their extinct thousands of years ago, but to their surprise, they're still around. They're rediscovered in the mid-70s, which is amazing animals out there this large that have yet to be discovered. Down on the right-hand side, the statues of those extinct species that used to live here. Now before I talk about this critter right up front, just take a quick peek over there in the back right. You'll see the kids climbing up on top of that statue of a big cat. But folks, that is the size of the American lion. There used to be lions in this part of the world, so naturally we have that statue next to the modern-day counterpart, the African lions right over here. And the female right up front, the male looks like he just got startled. It's right smack in the center there. He kind of jumped up here a second ago. Maybe he got startled by some noise or so. But this is a male named Amari. And I've seen many males in captivity. This by far has got to be one of the most impressive males that I've seen anywhere. It is just a magnificent specimen. It's supposed to be a... Females are the ones that basically do all the work. They go out and hunt, bring back food for the entire family. And they're all standing next to a little bit of function. As you take a look in there, you'll see that there is a feeding dish there, basically. They're great. Also, the skin, not the skin, but the trunk of it, is rough, creates a little bit of a scratching post for them. Provides shade, has heaters, also has sprinklers for the summertime to keep them a little bit on the cool side. There's also dangling objects from it there where the keepers can kind of lower them at will and have some special treats for the elephants, that is. That way the elephants don't just stand around in one part or one place to eat the dangling objects from it.
Let's see.
So we have two keepers in there doing a tag team there. There is a whistle.
Yes, they're elephants.
The elephants, when they've done the correct behavior that was asked. Everything's done by positive reinforcement. They are rewarded for the behaviors they are asked for, and any behavior that's undesirable, they just don't hear. The male is the big guy you see right over here on this side. His name is Ranjapur. Ranjapur is about 42 years old, weighing in at about 12,000 pounds. He is enormous. First time we've had a male here in my tenure. I've been working here for over 25 years, and it's the first time again we've had a male elephant. Take a look at the tusks too. See how they're kind of on the blunt side at the end? Well, part of it had to be removed in order for it to fit in the crate in order to transport them down here from our wild animal park. The estimate on each one of those of tusks is over 100 pounds each. Found right above Australia, and I've been to that jungle island on numerous occasions. I have seen these animals out in the wild. This here is a warthog found in southern Africa. Warts in their face are not true warts, they're cartilage that serve the same function as rubber bumpers in a car, that when they fight, they do not injure themselves as much. You'll never guess what his name is. His name is Andy Warthog. They fight, they do not. Females have the yellow throat, while the female has got a blue throat. I think she was in the nest. And look at what he's doing. He regurgitated some food. He's going to put the food in there and try to feed the female. Oh, the female's up above. But see how he's feeding her right now, giving her some treats? He's flirting with her. And she's walking away, so I guess the answer is no. Washington, D.C. But I'll tell you what, though. I'll give you a little surprise. On December 1st, we had another baby. And it's coming around right now. It's just coming between the two enclosures there. There he is. Little male there still. You can see that there's still a little bit of the umbilical cord attached there still. That'll be falling off soon. When he was first born, almost textbook size, about 6 feet tall, about 148 pounds. When female giraffes are giving birth, they don't lay down, so the baby has to fall head first 6 feet onto the ground. That's why they have those little bumps on their head. Just joking, that falls. There's a couple of functions. First of all, it severs the umbilical cord, and it also helps the animal take its first breath. Very long tongues. Tongues measure about 15 to 18 inches in length, used for grasping leaves off of high branches, and it can also be used for cleaning their eyes, nose, and ears with. And boys, to see that tongue whip right out and pick its nose, it's always a riot. Favorite foods on the wild are the leaves of the acacia tree, and the stuff they're nibbling on, that those feeding towers are all examples of acacias. They're from East Africa. Looking to the right-hand side, we have the boys over there out right now. We have some rhinoceroses, about 3 and 4 years old. Names are Saman and Sarat. They're still youngsters. And they end up being somewhere in the 4,500-pound range. There they are. Indian rhinos have this armor-like characteristic to their body. All the Asian rhinoceroses have this armor-like characteristic, but these are the ones that have the least amount of hair of all of the others. And they're going, and now they're gone. And very poor eyesight, only can see about 20 or 30 feet in front of them. Hi, folks, you're coming into a quiet zone, so I and the microphone cannot talk.
Hey, good day. Take
to the other end. But in the meantime, you'll
name
be able to
animal.
Enjoy some Sicilian donkeys, there are some kangaroos,
the rhinoceros.
Some flamingos, also some
that's right, they're rhinos.
Giant anteaters.
What was over there?
Giraffes.
Stand for honesty. Giraffes are insincere, and the elephants are kindly, but they're dumb.
Hey, Brittany, tell us what we're seeing.
Giraffes.
Where are giraffes from?
What did she say?
Okay, and you're in college right now? I'm sorry.
Africa.
There we go. That's it.
Yeah.